First of all, I would like to welcome all of you. Some of you are new families here at Independence Middle School. Your son or daughter's first time here. Welcome to the IMS 7th grade music family. Very much appreciate them being part of the program, and we're excited as directors to have them part of what we do here. We're a little different than Neil Armstrong, and we do grade level concerts here so that you as parents can see what the whole department does. So this evening, we started out in the cafeteria. I certainly hope those lights are dimming. Are they dimming? Good. All right. And we start with our stage band out in the cafeteria. It's combined 7th and 8th grade students who play, all right, Mr. Schilling. They play a certain arrangement of music, a jazz, rap, Latin, rock. And any student, it's different than a jazz band. We're going to have what they have call a wind ensemble later in the year, but the jazz band is a particular group of instruments. If you saw or heard us and your son or daughter is interested, they just need to come and talk to me and we'll get them involved, okay? So what we're doing here this evening is highlighting the 7th grade in not only the band, but the orchestra, the chorus, and also the handbells. The handbells is a group that meets once a week after school. It's extracurricular, just like the stage band. And they will, you know, Mr. McDowell, who's the conductor, will definitely tell you a little more about that. But we are anxious to show off what the kids have been working on for the last couple months and put hopefully some holiday spirit into your hearts here to start off the season. So on behalf of the administration here at Independence Middle School, I'd like to welcome you to the annual holiday concert here at Independence Middle School. Thank you, and sit back and relax.
Since Mr. Petrosi so graciously volunteered me to speak and explain what the bells are, I think I might say a few words. My name is Jay McNell. I'm the 8th grade general music teacher here at IMS. This is a group of 7th and 8th graders that participate in various ensembles and a number of other extracurricular activities that make scheduling a little bit interesting. I think we've had 2 rehearsals so far where we had everybody, right?
Yeah.
So they're doing a great job. And what you may not realize about the bells that makes them a little bit challenging is no one student gets to play the melody. They have to rely on one another. They have to feed from one person to the next to make sure they get all the notes that are supposed to happen at the right time. So it makes it a little bit of a different experience from the other ensembles that you'll hear tonight. It is a great group, and we are always looking for new members, so if there are any other string chorus or band people hiding behind the curtain that would like to join us for the spring, please do. Thank you. Thank you.
was kind of interesting because, I don't know, something happened in the audience, but one eyeball was on the music, and all of a sudden, I saw another eyeball looking somewhere else. So, Mr. Schilling, I don't know what you did, but I guess thank you. You don't know? Okay. All right, great. Anyway, so we like to finish our portion of the program with what I call kibbles and bits, and that is, it's actually Christmas bits and pieces, but every time we go to rehearse it in class, we call it kibbles and bits, because the hope, okay, I guess it wasn't funny. So anyway, so we're just going to go on. Thank you again for attending, and this is the end of the seventh grade band portion, and we'll move on to the chorus then. Thank you again.
Direct the 7th and 8th grade choruses here, and the group behind me is just a joy to work with. They are full of energy all the time. They often inspire me to do things that I didn't even plan to do. As if you notice in our program, our very last number says that it's not just arranged by Tina Chin, but it's also arranged by the 7th grade chorus, because they started giving me all these ideas, and then we just decided to put them all together. Starting off with a creative song for our first number in the concert. It's called I Believe. It's not a traditional holiday piece. We had started learning it early on. And when we pulled out some of the holiday music, the kids said, well, are we singing I Believe? I said, no, that's just to have in our repertoire, good, nice piece to learn. And they said, well, Mrs. Klinkway, why not? It talks about all the real gifts of the holidays. Peace, love, joy, all of the things that are the most important. And when they said that, we had to begin our concert with that. So I'm not going to speak the rest of the evening. I want to thank you for allowing me to work with your children. I hope you enjoy our part of the program, and we certainly wish you a very happy holiday season.
Baby born in Bethlehem. steam is coming soon. Now you dear old man, whisper what you'll bring to me. Tell me if you can. Up on the housetop, reindeer paws. Out jumps good old Santa Claus. Down through the chimney with lots of toys. All for the little ones' Christmas joys. Ho, 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 ho.
One of our high school students, Mr. Joe Serafini, who came back to play the piano for us this evening. Thank you so much. And Ian Marcos, I would like to thank you so much.
Thank you. much for coming to tonight's concert. I'm excited for you to hear the 7th grade orchestra tonight. They prepared 4 selections. And I feel like there's nothing like music to really get you in the holiday spirit, so I hope you've enjoyed the concert. Just a few announcements. In our 3rd selection, Rhythmic Snapshots of Christmas, we have a few soloists. On violin, Samantha Stinson, Claudia Huber, Jack Hare, and Courtney Neer. And on the last piece, we have some extra help tonight. We have Ian Merkel, a high school student on piano, and his younger brother, Sean, playing electric guitar on that final piece. So I hope you enjoy our selections. And just one more thing, happy birthday to my daughter, who's in the audience. She's 5 today. Happy birthday, Samantha.
Thank you.
Thank you.
evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is George Solaris, and I'm the proud assistant principal here at Independence Middle School. On behalf of our staff and students here at Independence, I would like to take a moment to acknowledge the instructors who have provided our young musicians with the guidance and enthusiasm to make them sound so spectacular each and every day. Our orchestra director, Mrs. Stephanie Glover, our handbells director, Mr. Jay McDowell, our choral director, Mrs. Tricia Quinque, and our band director, Mr. Michael Petrosi. Please join me in a very well-deserved round of applause. One more special thank you to a very important supporting cast member, the man who provides all the holiday ambiance in the building and a touch of real snow, Mr. Jeff Schilling. Hi, this guy. Thank you, Mr. Schilling. And last and most importantly, to our seventh grade musicians, your dedication to be exemplary is truly outstanding. Thank you for starting off our exciting holiday season in a manner that has put music into our hearts as we begin our year-end celebration with family and friends. Audience, please join me in a most appreciated round of applause for these exceptional and superior young musicians. We are so very proud of you. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our show for this evening. Once again, thank you for sharing the evening with us. Have a most enjoyable and safe holiday season. Good night.
Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, tangle the hall with bells on bobbing, bobble it all one way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
And to this day, Chris, Scrooge is synonymous with greed or miser, which just goes to show you the impact Dickens had on the English language.
He's a hack, and his portrayal of ghosts is borderline offensive.
Huh. Oh, hey, George.
Who's this?
Oh, this is the ghost of Christmas Chris. Christmas Chris, did I say that right? That's a bit of a tongue twister. Are you sure you don't want to change it? All right. Well, anyway, Chris here has been helping me out this holiday season.
What do you need him for when you got me?
Maybe because I can do this.
So what? I can do this.
I can see through walls.
So can I.
I can haunt the courtyard.
I can haunt the halls.
I can make myself as big as King Kong.
I can make myself as big as Godzilla.
Well, I can reenact a scene from Ghost.
Can you get this penny out of my face?
Well, I can reenact the scene from Ghostbusters.
It's time for me to show you the door.
Oh yeah? You and whose army?
Fellas, is this any way for holiday spirits to behave?
I guess so.
All right, come on, show a little Christmas cheer. That's much better. And I'm glad we got that squared away, because honestly, you're not the only two ghosts helping me out this year.
How am I going to fight with him?